Hi everyone, so in this lecture we'll start with the second module. So in the second module we have relational model, relational algebra, then mapping conceptual design into logical design and SQL. First we'll see what are the concepts behind relational model. The relational model of data is based on the concept of a relation. So relation, the concept you have studied in mathematics. So the same concept will be applied in the relational model. A relation is a mathematical concept which is based on the ideas of sets. Okay, so relation is a mathematical concept which is based on the ideas of sets. And the strength of the relational approach to the data management, it comes from the formal foundation provided by the theory of relations. So in your mathematical concepts or mathematics, you have studied relations in the set theory. So the same concept will be applied here. Now we'll see the informal definitions of these relations. Relation means it's a table of values. It can be defined as a table of values, or it can be viewed as a table of values. When I say table of values, then it will have a set of rows or set of columns. We can thought a relation as a set of rows or set of columns. Now each row in this table or the relation, it represents a fact that corresponds to a real world entity. Okay, it corresponds to a real world entity or some relationships. Okay, so each row represents a fact that corresponds to a real world entity or relationship. And each row has a set of values. Okay, it will have a set of values, and that uniquely identifies that row in the table. Now each row indicates, or it is formed using a set of values for a particular entity type. Okay, now how we are going to identify these rows or the different values or different entity types. So we'll use some row IDs or the sequential numbers. Okay, so if you have not specified anything, then automatically it will generate the row IDs or the sequence numbers. Sometimes we will use those row IDs or the sequential numbers to identify the rows in the table. And each column, typically it is called as column name or column header. Okay, it will be called by its column name or the column header. So these column headers are nothing but the attribute names. See, each row indicates an instance of an entity type. Okay, it's a combination of values. Now what values you're going to store? So those are the values corresponding to the properties of an entity type, which are nothing but attributes. So your columns in the table will be called by column name or the column header. Those are nothing but the attribute names. Now when I say it's a collection of values, a relation is a collection of tuples or the rows, and in each row is formed by collection of different values. Now how we are taking these values? From where we have to take, or how we have to assign these values? So these values will be taken from a particular domain of an attribute. Okay, now what does mean by domain? A domain is a set of atomic values, or we can say it is a set of permitted values for an attribute. Okay, set of permitted values for an attribute. So from these sets only, we have to take the value and we need to assign to the different attributes. Okay, so atomic means what? Atomic means it cannot be divisible further. Okay, it cannot be divided further. So that will be called as atomic. So in the relation, when you are storing the values, you have to store only the atomic values. Okay, single value and simple valued attributes. Now here, when I say it's a collection of values, now how we can define the relation schema? relation schema, it will be denoted by the set of attributes. Okay, it will be denoted using a capital letter R. You can see in the slide R, and it is having a set of attributes K1, K2, AN. These are the different attributes of an entity type. So here relation schema R, R is nothing but the name given to the relation schema, and it is made up of the different attributes. Each attribute in this schema will be like it will take the value from its domain. Okay, so AI, attribute AI, it is the name given to the different attributes or the properties, and those properties will take the values from their corresponding domain. So here D denotes the domain. Okay, D denotes domain, and we can say domain of AI, that means the what all the permitted values that can be represented using domain of AI. Now we'll see what is mean by degree of the relation. The degree or arity of a relation, it's the number of attributes of its relation schema. So in the previous slide, I said relation means it's like you'll be having a list of attributes, right? Now in that schema, how many attributes I have, that number will give you the degree of the relation. Okay, degree or arity means how many attributes that entity type has. So that will give you the degree of an relation. Okay, degree of the relation or arity of the relation. Now how we can define relation or relation state? In the previous we have seen relation schema. Now we'll see what is mean by relation, or sometimes it is called as relation state. It will be denoted by small letters, like in capital R is used for denoting relation schema, and small r indicates it's a relation or relation state. So relation state of any schema will be denoted as R of capital R, and it is a set of n tuples. Tuples means the rows. Okay, row will be called as tuple in the relation state. So n tuples will form a relation state. That means at any given time, if you check how many rows or the tuples are there, so that will give you the relation state. Now what does each tuple will have? As I said, the row will have a combination of values or collection of values for different attributes, right? So that can be represented with small v. Okay, so v1, v2, vn, these are the values which are taken from the domain of corresponding attributes. Okay, so T is a tuple, and it is formed by the combination or the by taking all values of attributes. Okay, and the term relation intension is used to represent or to tell the relation schema. Relation intention. And relation extension is used to name relation state. Okay, it's like a snapshot which you have taken at any given time. Okay, so that's why it is called as relation extension. And relation schema will be called as relation intention. Now how we can define this relation schema and the relation state in mathematical terms? So mathematically, the relation means it's a subset of Cartesian product of the domains that define relation schema. Kids, if I take the domain of all the attributes, if I take Cartesian product of the domains of all attributes, so you'll get a few large set, right? And from this set, I'll take few values or few combinations. So that will give you the relation state. Okay, so relation state, or the simply relation, means it is a subset of a Cartesian product of the domains that defines the relation schema R. Now here the Cartesian product specifies all possible combination of values. Okay, when we say Cartesian product means it will take all the combinations of the values, right? So the Cartesian product specifies all possible combination of values from the underlying domains. Now the total number of values or cardinality in domain will be given by the total number of tuples in the Cartesian product. Okay, so how we are calculating this, how we will get how many number of tuples are there in the table. So that can be given by the, first you have to take the cardinality of each domain and take the Cartesian product of that. So those many tuples can be formed or possible in the relation state. That means, I'll give an example. For if you consider attribute A, it can have 8 possible values, 8 different values it can take. And attribute A2, okay, so attribute A1 can have 8 different set of values. That means domain will have 8 different values, and attribute A2 can take 5 different values. Okay, so domain of A1 has 8 values and domain of A2 is having 5 values. Now how many different tuples can be possible? So you have to take the product of these two, 8 into 5. So 40 different combination can be possible. That means the total number of values or the total number of tuples in the Cartesian product can be 40. Okay, so out of this 40, maybe like I may have only 10 tuples in the relation. Okay, but total possible values, I'm saying it can be 40. Okay, and from that 40 values, I may have 10 different tuples in the relation. And the current relation state means it's the state at a given time. A relation state at a given time is called current relation state. Now we'll see the example. Here student is the relation. Okay, so relation name is student. That means you are giving name to this relation, a student. Like it is like entity type. We have seen in the ER model, entity relationship model, what is meant by entity. So entity will be any thing or object which present in the real world and about which we are storing the information in the database, correct? So here student represents an entity type. So here relation name means it is student, and what all the attributes it is having? So it is having name, SSN, home phone, address, office phone, age and GPA. So these are the different attributes. Okay, as I said, the column will be called or represented by the name of the attribute. Okay, column header. So here column headers are nothing but the attribute names. Okay, and the tuples. So here I can have, so here you can see a total 5 different tuples we have. Okay, 5 different tuples we have. So this is one of the relation state, example for the relation state. So at present we have 5 tuples in student relation. Now what are the characteristics of relations? Ordering of tuples in a relation, ordering of values within a tuple and alternative definition of a relation, then values and nulls in tuples, and then interpretation of a relation. We'll see one by one. A relation is a set of tuples, correct? It will have a set of tuples. Now in this tuple, like in the relation, the tuples may not be ordered. That means I can have in different order. Like first I will store one record and then next it can be interchanged with other. So order of tuples does not matter in the relation. Okay, so relation is not sensitive to the ordering of the tuples. Because you see, when I say relation, the main concept is taken from the set theory, right? If I say a set of fruits, okay, I have a set of fruits like apple, mango, and banana. Okay, so I'll say set S is having apple, mango, and banana. Now, if I interchange these fruit names, for example, next I'll write banana first, and then apple, and then mango. Whether these two sets are different? No, right? So it's actually the same set. So that ordering doesn't matter, correct? Whatever values we have, we can change the order of those values in the set. So similarly, in the relation, the ordering of the tuples are not considered, okay? So the tuples are not considered to be ordered, even though it appears like a table or tabular form, but the ordering is not considered, okay? So we'll see the example. Employee relation. In employee relation, I have four different tuples. So initially, I have entered T1 first, then T2, T3, T4. In this order, I have entered the values, okay? And now, if it is changed, for example, T4 appears first, and then T1, T3, and T2. See here, the ordering of these tuples are changed now. But both are same relation because I have the same information in both the tables, right? Both the instances. Or if I say this is state S1, relation state S1, and this is relation state S2. But in both the states, I have same information. So that's why the ordering of the tuples will not be considered in the relation. Okay, even though it is shuffled, but it will not affect the data stored in the table or the relation. Okay, then when I say the ordering of tuples are not considered, but what happens? Ordering of the values within the tuple. So each tuple is a set of values, right? That means a set of values of different attributes. Now, within the tuple, these values must be ordered. Okay, within the tuple, these values must be ordered. Okay, so from the definition of the relation, n tuple is an ordered list of values. So the ordering of values in a tuple is very important. Ordering of tuples can be changed, but the values which you have within the tuple, it must be ordered. That is the mandatory condition. Okay, and alternatively, how we can define this relation schema and the relation states? A relation schema, it is a set of attributes, like it is shown R equal to A1, A2, AN, and a relation state. Relation state is a finite set of mappings, where each tuple is a mapping from relation schema to domain. Okay, so here D is the union of all attributes. So in your relation state, each tuple must be mapped from relation schema to union of domains. That means here in the relation schema, if I say relation schema, that is the definition, okay, definition of the relation, that means you will say employee is having employee ID, employee name, salary, and employee department number. So this gives you the relation schema, set of attributes. Now, I have employee ID first and then employee name after employee ID, right? So in the same order, you have to store the information. So here you can see T1 is having 111 and then Govind 20,001. And in the second tuple, again employee ID will come first and then name Adarsh, then salary 15,000, and then the department number. If you observe this table, in each tuple, okay, or in every tuple, you can see employee ID is coming first, and then name, and then salary, and after that department number. So this ordering of the values must be maintained in every tuple. Okay, is that clear? So in every tuples, you have to see that the ordering of the values must be maintained. I cannot store Adarsh first and then 112 here in the tuple 2. It is not correct or it is not valid. Okay, so ordering within the tuples is mandatory. Now we'll see values and nulls in the tuples. All values are considered atomic. As I said, the values which we are assigning or the domain of each attribute must have the atomic values. Okay, the set of permitted values from which we are assigning the values to different attributes, so those must be atomic. It cannot be divided further. Okay, indivisible. It is not divided. So this, because of this, it is termed as flat relational model, because we don't have any composite attributes or the multi-valued attributes. It look like a flat structure. Okay, just the rows and the columns. That's why it is called as flat relational model. Now, as I said, for the values or for the column values, you are taking the permitted values from the corresponding domains, right? In some cases, the values which you are assigning, it is not available or it is not applicable in that particular entity instance. In that case, you can use a special value called null value. Okay, so a special null value is used to represent the values that are unknown or inapplicable, or it is not applicable to certain tuples. Say for example, Aadhaar number you have to enter, or PAN number you take. PAN number you have to enter. Okay, so in the table you have an attribute called PAN number. Now, if you don't have a PAN number, then what value you can insert? So in that case, you can put null value. Okay, you can specify null. So it is not available, or it is unknown, or it is not applicable. Okay, so that is another thing where if you don't know the exact value or if it is not applicable, then you can put a special null value for the column, for the attribute. Now we'll see the interpretation of a relation. In each table or the relation, the tuple actually represents an instance of the entity type. Okay, the relation schema can be interpreted as a declaration or a type of assertion. That means I say what all the attributes I have in the relation, so that I will represent in the relation schema. And for example, schema of the student means it will have name, SSN, home phone, address, office phone, age, and GPA. So I'm just telling, okay, this is something which is there in the real world. Okay, so and what all the properties it is having. So that assertion or the declaration we are writing in the relation schema. And each tuple in the relation, it can be interpreted as a fact, or a particular instance of the relation. If I say student is the relation schema, so student is the relation schema, and in the student relation, I have 10 different students' information. That means each tuple represents the information about one student. Okay, so each tuple represents some information about the student, or it represents a student. Okay, it represents a student. So like that, tuple in the relation can be interpreted as a fact or the particular instance of the relation. Clear? Now here, if I say there are 5 different tuples are there. So this student schema actually defines the declaration, or it tells what all the properties the student can have. And tuples, or the in the relation state, tuples indicates, for example, Dick Davidson is a student, and his information or details are stored in the first row or first tuple. So the tuple 1 represents Dick Davidson, tuple 2 represents Barbara Benson. So like that, you can have the different instances of relation student. Okay, here don't confuse with the relation and relationship. Here relation indicates a schema or the entity type. Okay, relation means it's correspond to entity type. So student entity type. So here tuple 1 indicates Dick Davidson's information. So he is one instance. He is an instance of student. Okay, so like that we have 5 different students, and their information is stored in different tuples. Now we'll see what all the different notations used in the relational model. To represent the relation schema, as I said, we'll use the capital letters. Okay, so R and the degree N is denoted by R within brackets. You have to specify like attribute A1, A2 up to AN. Okay, and QRS, the capital QRS can be used to denote the relation names. Then small QRS denotes the relation states, and then small letters T, U, V denotes the tuples. And you can use small letter V to indicate the value of particular attribute. V1 means it is the value taken from the set of permitted values of attribute A1. Okay, so these are the different notations we are using in the relational model. Now the next topic is related to different constraints. So that I will take in the next session. So thanks for listening. Thank you.